questions for you.
Let's do it.
First and foremost, are you single?
Am I single? Ooh.
Not at the moment.
Ooh. Sorry, 2012 New Year's. Sorry. Okay. So, most question that people want to know is, how did you get your start? Because it's kind of an interesting story, so go ahead and...
Yeah, I started performing on Third Street Promenade down in Santa Monica, California. Just street performing, busking, the guitar case open, people put in money. And I paid my rent for like 3 years doing that.
Did you really?
Yeah.
You made enough to do that? Holy crap. That's amazing. Know, well, you're amazing, like, live, which I'm shocked because most people are... But you're really good life, so we want to thank you for being here, first and foremost.
Yeah.
Second of all, if you weren't doing what you're doing now, where would you be?
I have no idea.
No? Well, you got your degree. What did you get your degree
in? I got my degree in music business.
Really?
Yeah.
So would you kind of...
I guess something in the music business, but I mean, I don't know. That's the whole thing. I don't have any other option. There was nothing else to do. That's why I stayed out the street.
This
don't go
it.
Out to the street unless you unless there's nothing else you can do, yeah.
Okay. We had a random question. What is your favorite cereal?
Ooh. It's different. There's like a couple different types. Like if you're just talking about what tastes the best and there's no repercussions, Cookie Crisp is the jam.
Cookie Crisp.
Yeah.
Okay.
But you can't eat Cookie Crisp all the time. You'll die. So.
So well, you're not having it 24/7.
Exactly. So just like a standard, you know, like Raisin Bran.
Raisin Bran, like the Fiber One for you.
Yeah, that type of stuff. I eat that now. Yeah.
That's what I eat. So we got some questions on Twitter.
Okay.
Lois321 wants to know, what was your first reaction when you heard Keep Your Head Up on the radio?
It's just kind of surreal. It's so cool because what the radio does is it's just such a widespread thing. So now I get to come to Sacramento and there's people here that want to say hi. It's really different for me. It's really awesome.
Okay. You say you love love. So would you rather be in love with someone or be loved by someone?
I think that neither of those without the other one is good.
You got to choose. This is a game.
I'd rather love someone.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. Would you rather spend the rest of your life without a significant other, or would you rather have a partner who is extremely difficult?
Extremely difficult. I mean, I think everybody's extremely difficult.
Ooh.
Like, talk to someone who's been married for 50 years. Ask them about the other person. They'll say they're extremely, extremely difficult.
Okay. What do you wear to bed?
What do I wear to bed? On the bus now. This is my first tour with the tour bus, so. And there's like girls on the bus and stuff, so.
Okay, when you're at home.
When I'm at home.
Yeah.
Yeah. Just like some shorts.
Shorts, yeah. Boxers, briefs.
Sure.
First thing you do when you wake up in the morning?
Brush my teeth and like warm up my voice.
Warm up your voice. Mm-hmm. And last thing you do before you go to bed?
Wash my face.
Really?
Yeah.
Keeping up with the facial?
I try. I do not have the best skin. I try.
Okay. If you knew tomorrow was your last day on Earth, how would you spend it?
I think I'd do just what I'm doing today.
That's it?
Would
you do like an outrageous concert on like the rooftop somewhere or just a more intimate?
I would do just what I'm doing today. I would love to be in Sacramento rocking a show. I swear. Like that sounds like a lie. This is awesome.
There you go. We had a question about first big purchase you made when you very first got your big paycheck.
Yeah. Still kind of waiting on that. I got a car, which was nice. Like
okay.
Just like a Tahoe.
Yeah.
Which was good to go around the country in. Mm-hmm. I'd been rocking a minivan before that, so. It was seriously an upgrade.
Classy.
Yeah, totally.
You say on your Twitter you are a beatboxer.
Yeah.
Give me your best beatbox. There you go. I'm impressed.
Cool.
Questions? Yes.
Who's your dream collaboration?
I just love hip hop. So anybody that does great, great hip hop. Lupe Fiasco, I love Common, I love Jay-Z. Any of those, I'm in. Yeah.
In school, what would you get in trouble for?
I didn't get in trouble. I was like, I just wouldn't do that. I like to follow the rules. I'm like stupid like that. Like I don't like to cut in line. That stresses me out. I don't wanna be annoying to anybody. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Not even like talking in class or.
I mean, no.
You had to be some kind of pain in the ass.
Nobody's that perfect. I'm like annoying. I'll be annoying, but I won't break the rules. Yeah. I don't like to break the rules. Is that cheesy? I didn't do that. I didn't ever get
into.
I never went to detention. I was like a super jock in high school. Played basketball. So
how's your 3-point shot?
It's pretty good.
Yeah?
Yeah.
We don't have a basketball court, do we? No, not
I'm big on mini hoops. Like I have a mini hoop in my dressing room.
Oh. Every dressing room, yeah. A little foam ball.
Mm-hmm.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Taylor Swift.
Yes.
You go ahead. I'm gonna put you on the spot.
She is the coolest. We've hung out a little bit. I love her to death. She's an amazing songwriter. She brought me on stage to sing with her in Nashville, and I love her to death. She's a great friend.
I think the real question she's trying to ask is, yes. Did anything ever happen between you and Taylor Swift?
Nothing ever happened in a romantic sense, no.
Oh, well, good for the rest of you. Minus the girlfriend. Yeah. iPhone, Android, BlackBerry.
iPhone.
Do you have a ritual before you go on stage, or is there like a certain song you need to listen to?
This tour we do because it's ridiculous. And my friend, my drummer started it, and he, every time that he would say hi to me, he would come up and say some ridiculous take on using the word bro. Like, what's up, bro? But he'd be like, what's up, Napoleon Bonaparte? Or like, Abraham Lincoln. So that's what we do. We go around the circle, and everybody has to say one of those before we go on stage.
Okay.
It's ridiculous. A good one yesterday was Bro DiMaggio, bro. That was good.
Do you guys get like in a little huddle and just kind of like go for it?
It was good.
I don't even know what to say to that. So I'll top it off with this question. Which way does your toilet paper hang, like top or bottom? Does it go this way or this way? Does it not matter?
It doesn't. I don't have a specific one.
You're not OCD on the toilet paper?
It's fine, yeah. It's going to be fine.
Okay. Fill in the blank.
Okay.
I am.
So excited. Seriously.
I like.
Pizza.
I love.
Music.
I hate.
When people talk about other people badly.
I would never.
What'd you say? Break the rule. Yeah, I don't like. I'm not like a goody two-shoes. I just don't want to piss people off. Yeah, I don't want to, like, cutting in line sucks. If you cut someone in line and then the whole rest of the line's like, that guy's. I don't like to do that. I don't like to cut in line. Yeah. I would never cut in line.
Okay. Yes. I use my right hand to blank, but my left hand for blank.
I use my.
He plays guitar. Hold on. You nasties.
Yeah, my right hand to strum and my left hand to do this.
I can't eat my chicken nuggets without blank.
Ranch.
Monkey see monkey.
I feel like there should be a clever answer, but I don't know. Do?
It's whatever you want it to be. It takes blank licks to get to the center of the lollipop.
Oh, man, I don't know. There is an actual number, right? He says it was like one, a two.
I don't know. I was asking
we'll
you. Maybe you
I'll
know.
I'll go with two.
I'm staying at the blank.
I'm staying at the bus. That's where I stay.
Safe answer. My guilty pleasure is?
Taco Bell. I do.
What specific item?
Chalupa.
Oh.
Chalupas are great.
Okay.
I know.
One of your favorite songs at the moment?
What's really good right now? I love a song called Count On Me by Matt Kearney. Really good.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah.
That one's good.
It's great.
Would you rather see a movie at the theater or at home on DVD?
Theater.
Really?
Yeah, totally. If I have a second.
Like the full experience?
Yeah.
Okay. Are you a spender or a saver?
A little bit of both. Right down the middle. Spaver.
Spaver. UrbanDictionary.com, that one later today. It'll be up there. Do you think men should pay for dates or do you think women should?
I mean, I'm into paying for a date if you have the money to. I don't think you should not go on a date because you can't pay. That's
okay.
What I should say.
If someone offered you $1 million for a night of sex, would you do it? And would it matter if they were good looking or not?
I would definitely not do it.
No? Not even for $1 million? No. How about $1 billion?
No.
Oh, you play it too safe. Favorite karaoke song?
Journey, Don't Stop Believin'.
Okay. If you could be an animal, what animal would you want to be?
Dog. I love dogs.
Really? Any specific kind of dog?
It doesn't really matter. Great Dane. I want to get a Great Dane.
What would you name your Great Dane?
I don't know. Yeah, I haven't gotten there yet.
You love pizza. What's your favorite pie?
Just straight plain. But you have to be able to walk and eat it. That's the problem with California, you guys. You guys here.
You're a New Yorker.
Yeah, like you should be able to walk in and there should be a glass case with a bunch of different slices. And it's fast. You just like, you get it really quickly. The person behind the counter is like a little bit pissed off. It's awesome. And you pay for it real fast and then you leave. Here you walk in. I tried to do that.
Yeah,
I got to California. I see a pizza sign. I go in to get it. They're like, would you like to take a seat? We do personal pimp. I'm like, get out of my face. What the hell is going on here? I want to get in and get out of here. It's like a whole process here.
All right.
It's frustrating.
Now he's angry. Yeah. This is why he doesn't like to get angry. Yeah. If you were a teacher, which subject would you teach?
Music or theater or something like artistic.
Something entertainment. Yeah. Favorite home-cooked meal when you are home? Because I know you're on the road a lot.
Yeah, I love salmon.
Salmon and?
Salmon vegetables. Keep it simple. It's great.
Can you cook it?
Yeah.
That's a no. Kind of.
Sure.
Favorite adult beverage?
I don't drink, actually.
Really? Yeah. That is impressive. Yeah. Any specific reasons? Why? Do you get too crazy? I do.
No, I don't. I don't get too crazy.
Forget where you are, maybe.
Yeah.
No? How much five-hour energy drink do you drink? Because I was told...
A lot.
Like, do you go through, like, cases and cases? So you're five-hour energy
so
and not a
Red
Bull.
Yeah, five-hour energy is the fastest way. When I'm on tour, there's, like, so little sleep that those things help me out.
Really? How many
There's no study yet that says I'm going to die, right?
No, they're pretty safe as long as you have them within moderation, but you have to, like, drink water.
Yeah, that's what
Otherwise,
I
you're going to have a heart attack, and then that'll be a different song on a new album.
Mm-hmm.
Speaking of which... Your last album came out last year in June.
Yes.
When's the new album coming?
Oh, man, I would love it. I've got a lot of new songs I've been writing and I'm excited about. I don't have a date yet, but... yeah, though, if you come tonight, I'll play a new one.
So are we looking towards the end of the year, next year?
I know, I honestly have no idea. I'm just trying to get done with this tour. And
You're killing me, man.
I'm sorry. I mean, that's a lot of questions that I answered.
I know.
I don't think I'm killing you.
But the most important, the album.
I know. That's coming.
Okay.
That's all I got.
Well, that's good. Well, thank you for being here.
Thank you so much for having me. You guys are awesome.